The KEBRA NEGAST. The Ethiopian Orthodox Christian Church Book of Kings. Podcast 6 of 6. 100. Concerning the angels who rebelled. And there were certain angels with whom God was wroth, now he, the knower of the heart, knew them, and they reviled Adam, saying, Since God hath shown love to him, he hath set us to minister unto him, and the beasts and creeping things, and the fish of the sea, and the birds of the air, and all fruits, and the trees of the field, and the heavens and the earth also, and he hath appointed the heavens to give him rain, and the earth to give him fruits. And the sun and the moon also hath he given him, the sun to give him light by day and the moon to give him light in the night season. He hath fashioned him with his fingers, and he hath created him in his own image, and he hath kissed him and breathed upon him the spirit of life, and he saith unto him, My son, my firstborn, my beloved. And he hath set him in a garden to eat and enjoy himself without sickness or suffering, and without toil or labor, but he hath commanded him not to eat from one tree. And being given all these things by God, Adam hath transgressed and eaten of that tree, and he hath become hated and rejected, and God hath driven him out of the garden, and from that time Adam hath abandoned his hope, for he hath transgressed the commandment of his Creator. And God answered the angels who reviled Adam in this wise, and he said unto them, Why do ye revile Adam in this wise? For he is flesh and blood and ashes and dust. And the angels answered and said unto him, May we declare before thee the sin of Adam? And God said unto them, Declare ye his sin, and I will hearken unto you, and I myself will answer you in respect of Adam my servant. For God had worked on behalf of Adam. And God said, I created him out of the dust, and I will not cast away that which I have fashioned. I brought him forth out of non-existence, and I will not make my handiwork a laughing stock for his enemies. And those angels said, Praise be unto thee, O Lord. For thou, the knower of hearts, knowest that we have reviled Adam because he hath transgressed thy commandment that he was not to eat of one tree after thou hadst made him Lord over everything which thou hast created, and hadst set him over every work of thy hands. And if thou hadst not told him, and if thou hadst not commanded him not to eat of one tree, there would have been no offense on his part, and if he had eaten because of a lack of food, there would have been no offense on his part. But thy word made him to know, and thou didst say, As surely as thou eatest of this tree thou shalt die. And he, after hearing this, made bold and ate. Thou didst not let him lack sweet fruits to eat from the garden, and thou didst not let him lack one to comfort him and a companion like unto himself. And these things we say and make known unto thee, and we have revealed unto thee how he hath transgressed thy commandment. And the merciful one and the lover of mercy answered them on behalf of Adam, and said unto them, You have I created out of fire and air with the one intent that ye should praise me. Him have I created of twice as many elements as you of dust and water, and of wind and fire, and he became a being of flesh and blood. And in him are 10 thoughts or intentions, 5 good, and 5 bad. And if his heart inciteth him to good, he walketh with good intent, and if the devil seduceth him, he walketh with him on an evil path. As for you, ye have no other object in your minds but praise of me, with the exception of that arrogant one who produced evil, and became an evil being, and was driven forth from your assembly. And now, why do ye magnify yourselves over Adam? If ye were as he is, and I had created you of water and dust, ye would have been flesh and blood, and ye would have transgressed my commandment more than he hath done, and denied my word. And the angel said unto him, Praise be unto thee, O Lord. Far be it from us. We will not transgress thy commandment, and we will not oppose thy word, for we are spiritual beings for life, and he is a creature of dust doomed to folly. And now try us well, and put us to the test so that thou mayest know whether we are able to keep thy word. And when they had vaunted themselves in this manner, God, the lover of men, said unto them, If now ye go astray so far as this in transgressing my word, the wrong will be upon your own heads, for Hahanam or hell, and fire, and sulfur, and fervent heat, and whirlwind shall be your habitation until the great day, ye shall be kept in chains which can neither be loosened nor broken forever. But if ye keep truly my word, and ye do my commandment, ye shall sit upon my right hand and upon my left. For everyone who hath conquered is mighty, and he who is conquered shall be overpowered. Now Satan hath no power whatsoever, for he hath only what he maketh to germinate in the mind, and he cannot grasp firmly, and he cannot perform anything, and he cannot beat, and he cannot drag, and he cannot seize, and he cannot fight, he can only make thoughts to germinate silently in the mind. And him who is caught by the evil mind he prepareth for destruction, and if a man hath conquered the evil mind he findeth grace and hath a reward which is everlasting. And to you, according to what ye wish, there shall be upon you the mind of a man and the body of a man. But take good heed to yourselves that ye transgress not my word and break not my commandment, and defile not ye yourselves with eating, or drinking, or fornication, or with any other thing whatsoever, and transgress ye not my word. And straightway there were given unto them with his word flesh and blood and a heart of the children of men. And they were content to leave the height of heaven, and they came down to earth, to the folly of the dancing of the children of Cain with all their work of the artisan, which they had made in the folly of their fornication, and to their singings, which they accompanied with the tambourine, and the flutes, and the pipes, and much shouting, and loud cries of joy and noisy songs. And their daughters were there, and they enjoyed the orgies without shame, for they scented themselves for the men who pleased them, and they lost the balance in their minds. And the men did not restrain themselves for a moment, but they took to wife from among the women those whom they had chosen, and committed sin with them. For God hath no resting place in the hearts of the arrogant and those who revile, but he abideth in the hearts of the humble and those who are sincere. And he spake in the gospel, saying, Woe be unto those who make themselves righteous, and despise their neighbors. And again he saith, God loveth the humble, and he holdeth lightly those who magnify themselves. And straightway God was wroth with them, and he bound them in the terror of Sheol until the day of redemption, as the apostle saith, he treated his angels with severity. He spared them not, but made them to dwell in a state of judgment, and they were fettered until the great day. The word of God conquered, who had fashioned Adam in his likeness or form, and those who had reviled and made a laughingstock of Adam were conquered. And the daughters of Cain with whom the angels had companied conceived, but they were unable to bring forth their children, and they died. And of the children who were in their womb some died, and some came forth, having split open the bellies of their mothers they came forth by their navels. And when they were grown up and reached man's estate they became giants, whose height reached unto the clouds, and for their sakes and the sakes of sinners the wrath of God became quiet, and he said, My spirit shall only rest on them for 120 years, and I will destroy them with the waters of the flood, them and all sinners who have not believed the word of God. And to those who believed the word of their fathers, and did his will, no injury came from the waters of the flood, but he delivered them, saying, If thou believest my word thou canst save thyself from the flood. And Noah said, O Lord, I believe thy word, make me to know by what means I can be saved. And God said unto him, Thou canst be saved from the water by wood. And Noah said, How, O Lord? And God said unto him, Make thyself a four-sided ark, and build it with the work of the carpenter, and make for it three stories inside, and go into it with all thy house. And Noah believed the word of God, and made the ark, and was saved. Now hearken ye unto me, and I will explain to you concerning this thing. When God gave the command he could have given unto Noah a wing like the eagle and transported him to the country of the living, with all his house, until his anger with the sinners who had not believed the word of God and the word of their fathers, had abated, or he could have lifted him up into the air, or he could have commanded the water of the flood which was like a wall not to approach the one mountain where he would make Noah to dwell with his sons and not to submerge the beasts and cattle which he wanted. But know ye this God was well pleased that by means of wood which had been sanctified the salvation of his creation should take place, that is to say, the ark and the wood of the cross. God said unto Noah, Make that whereby thou shalt be saved, that is to say, the tabernacle of the church, and when he said unto him, Make it four-sided, he showed that the sign of the cross was fourfold. Now the four corners of the ark are the horns of the altar, and he commanded Moses to make the ark out of indestructible wood. He said, Will sanctify thee by that heavenly and spiritual work of my hand. And do thou sanctify thyself from filth, and impurity, and fornication, and vindictiveness, and falsehood, together with thy brother and thy house. And sacrifice unto me a clean sacrifice with cleanness, and I will accept thee after thou hast sanctified thyself and thy house. Command all the people to sanctify themselves, for my holy things must be offered by holy ones. And this thou shalt seek, the tabernacle of my covenant which I have created for my praise. And if ye come with purity of heart, with love, and with peace, without mockery and reviling, and if ye will make right your hearts in respect of me and your neighbors, I will hear your prayers, and I will listen to your petitions about everything which ye submit to me, and I will come and be with you, and I will walk among you, and I will dwell in your hearts, and ye shall be unto me my people, and I will be your God in truth. 101. Concerning him that existeth in everything and everywhere. And again God said unto Moses, Make for me an open space before the courtyard of the tabernacle, no man who is impure sexually and unclean shall come there, and no one who is not pure. For I am there, and not only there, but in every place like there unto where my name is invoked in purity. I was with Daniel in the den of lions, and I was with Jonah in the belly of the great fish, and I was with Joseph in the pit, and I was with Jeremiah in the well fed from the lake. I stand under the deepest deep so that the mountains may not sink down under the waters, and I am under the waters so that they may not sink down upon the fire, and sulfur, I stand under the fire and sulfur so that they may not sink down upon the winds and the rust. I am under the winds and the rusty fog so that they may not sink down under the darkness. And I stand under the deepest darkness and under the abysses, and every created thing supporteth itself on me, and everything which I have created cometh to me as a place of refuge. I am above the earth, and I am at the ends of the world, and I am master of everything. I am in the air, my place of abode, and I am above the chariot of the cherubim, and I am praised everlastingly by all the angels and by holy men. And I am above the heights of heaven, and I fill everything. I am above the seven heavens. I see everything, and I test everything, and there is nothing that is hidden from me. I am in every place, and there is no other God besides me, neither in the heaven above nor in the earth beneath, there is none like unto me, saith God, my hand hath laid the foundation of the earth, and my right hand hath made strong the heavens, I and my Son and the Holy Spirit. 102. Concerning the beginning. As David prophesied by the mouth of the Holy Spirit, saying, With thee was the headship on the day of might. Now what do these words, day of might mean? Is it not the day whereon Christ, the word of the Father, created heaven and earth? For Moses saith in the beginning of the book, In the beginning God made the heavens and the earth. Understand then in the beginning meaneth in Christ, the interpretation of beginning is Christ. John the Apostle, the son of Zebedee, saith concerning Christ, This is the first or, beginning whom we have heard and seen, whom we have known, and whom our hands have felt. And we will relate unto you how we have a portion with him, and ye who believe our words shall have a portion with us. And Luke the disciple saith in the Acts of the Apostles, In the beginning we make speech concerning everything, and this that he saith shook that Christ was the redemption of all, and we believe in him. And Mark the evangelist in the beginning of his book wrote, saying, The beginning of the gospel is Jesus Christ, the Son of God, and these words mean that Christ was the glad tidings for the prophets and the apostles, and that we all have participated in his grace. And again John the evangelist wrote, saying, In the beginning was the Word, and that Word was with God, and in another place his Word showeth this plainly, and he saith, And likewise in the beginning was God the Word. And now observe that that Word of the Father is Christ, whereby he made the heavens and the earth and every created thing. It is he who created, and without him nothing that came into being, nothing whatsoever, he spake, and they came into being, he commanded, and they were created. And the third glorious thing, hearken to it, through the breath of his mouth he created all their host. This maketh manifest the Holy Spirit, who is clearly referred to. And what shall we say? Let us weep for them. Woe be unto the Jews and unto the pagans who have wandered from the truth and have refused to submit to the love of God, with which in his goodness he hath loved man. For after Adam was rejected through his sin he saved him by the greatness of his mercy, being crucified on the wood of the cross, his hands being pierced with nails. With his palm stretched out in humility, and his head bowed on one side, for our sakes he, to whom suffering was unfitting, suffered in the everlasting majesty of his Godhead. He died that he might destroy death, he suffered exhaustion that he might give strength to the wearied being of dust, athirst he drank vinegar, he was crowned with a crown of thorns, he feared not and was not ashamed of the contumely and hatred and spitting of the polluted Jews. He suffered beating, he was buffeted with fists, he was pierced, he was transfixed with nails, he was reviled and mocked, being God and the King of death, and the bestower of glory, and because of this he endured patiently all disgrace. Wearied and miserable, they made him sad when they rejected him and hated him, but strong and glorious, what could sadden him when they brought false charges against him? For he himself knew his Godhead, and he knew his glory, and he knew himself. And there was none who knew him, for he was the creator of everything. And if they had known him they would not have crucified the Lord of praise or glory. And he said in his mercy, Forgive them, Father, for they know not what they do. They likened their creator to something that had been created, and they slew a sojourner who did not belong to mortal creatures, and he was not a thing that had been made with the hand. But he himself was the maker, and he himself was the creator, light of light, God of God, Son of the Father, Jesus Christ. He was the refuge, he was the feeder, he was the director, he, whose domain was above what is on high, and above everything, abased himself. Even as Isaiah, the man of keen words among the prophets, saith, He was a humble man, and his appearance was rejected, like a root he hid himself in parched ground, he came in the flesh, a being of the earth, though he was the sustainer of the universe and the savior of the universe. And David ascribeth beauty to him, saying, On thy beauty and in thy goodliness of form. And again he saith, His form is more goodly than that of the children of men. And again he saith, Graciousness is poured forth from thy lips. And again he saith, Direct aright with prosperity, and reign through righteousness and justice and sincerity. And again he saith concerning the Jews, the enemies of the truth, thine arrows are sharp and strong in the hearts of the haters of the king, it is right that they should transfix their hearts, he saith unto those who did not wish me to be king, and they shall be brought before me and pierced with spears. And again Isaiah saith concerning the Jews, I have sought for them and found them not, I have called unto them and they have not answered me, I have loved them and they have hated me. And again David saith, They returned unto me evil for good, and they hated me in return for my love for them. And again Isaiah saith, With their lips they profess love for me, but in their hearts they keep afar from me, and their worshipping of me is an empty thing. And as Moses saith, They have moved me to wrath with their gods, and I will move them to jealousy with that which is not a nation, for they are a people whose counsel is destroyed. And those who said, We have no law, unto them hath the law been given, for God is the giver of the law unto every one. And God rewarded the Jews according to their wickedness, and he treated the Gentiles according to their simplicity. For he is merciful and compassionate to those who call upon him and who take refuge in him, and who purify themselves from all uncleanness in the church and in the tabernacle of the law of God, and he loveth those who weep and repent even as Stephen, one of the 70 disciples saith. Now among the 70 disciples there were 7 who were chosen for service with the 12 apostles, to perform service with Silas, and Barnabas, and Mark, and Luke, and Paul. And this Stephen spake unto the Jews whilst he was standing up to martyrdom and the Jews were killing him, and said unto them as he showed them their folly in not having kept the commandment of God, Ye have not kept the Torah according to the ordinance of the angels, as ye received it. And it saith in the Acts of the Apostles, when they heard this they went mad with anger and gnashed their teeth. Now hearken ye unto me. In his saying ye have not kept the Torah according to the order of the angels, we have a form and a foreshadowing of what is in the heavens, that is to say, the heavenly and free Jerusalem, the habitation of the Most High, whereof the situation and construction are incomprehensible to mortal heart. And in it is the throne of the Most High, which is surrounded with fire, and four beasts bear it in their place, which is the sixth heaven. And a throne goeth up to the seventh heaven, the habitation of the Father, and there dwelleth he who is with his Father and the Holy Spirit, who vivifieth everything. And the tabernacle of the church is a similitude of the Jerusalem which is in the heavens, and the church of the Gentiles is a similitude of the Jerusalem which is in the heavens. 103. Concerning the horns of the altar. Now, the tabernacle symbolizeth the horns of the altar, where the holy priests offer up sacrifice, whereon they place the tarapza, namely, table, the similitude of the grave wherein he namely, Christ was buried in Golgotha. And what is on the table, that is, the offering, is a symbol of the firstling, that is to say, the body of Emmanuel, or Akritos, the pure, the unmixed, which our Savior took from Mary, of the which he said unto his holy apostles, Eat ye my body, whosoever eateth not of my body hath no portion with me, and no everlasting life. But he who hath eaten my body, even though he be dead, shall live forever, for he is associated with my body and my blood, and he hath become my heir, and he shall say to my Father, Our Father which art in heaven, and the Father shall answer him, saying Thou art my Son, and the crown, which is above the offering, is a similitude of the stone with which the Jews sealed the grave. And when the priest saith, Send the Holy Spirit shall be sent, and the body of our Lord shall be perfect. And when we have received we shall be participators in the body and blood of our Lord and Redeemer Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, and the Holy Spirit, henceforth and forever. Speak ye then to one another so that the Jews, who are blind in heart, and who are our enemies and the enemies of our Lord God, may not boast themselves over us. And they say, Your gods are many, and ye worship wood, and they say, Preaching openly the word of Isaiah the prophet, ye worship the half of it, and with the other half ye cook the body and eat it. Now Isaiah speak thus in respect of those who worship graven images and idols. And they say that we say, These are our gods, and they have created us, and that we talk to them and worship them as the Lord our God. And these also are they whom the devils lead into error in their wickedness, and David saith, Concerning them, the gods of the heathen are devils, but God hath created the heavens, truth and goodness are before him. 104. More concerning the ark and the talk of the wicked. And as concerning the ark, God saved Noah in the ark. And God held converse with Abraham in the wood of Manbar, that is to say the wood that cannot be destroyed, and he saved Isaac by means of the ram which was caught in the thicket, and he made Jacob rich by means of three rods of woods which he laid in running water, and through the top of his staff Jacob was blessed. And he said unto Moses, Make a tabernacle of wood which cannot be destroyed, in the similitude of Zion, the tabernacle of the covenant. And when David took it from the city of Samaria, he placed the tabernacle of the law in a new tabernacle, and rejoiced before it. For from the beginning God had made the tabernacle the means of salvation, and very many signs and wonders were performed through it by its form and similitude. Hearken ye now unto me, and I will show you plainly how God had ordained salvation through the wood of his cross, in the tabernacle of his law, from the beginning to the end. Salvation came unto Adam through the wood. For Adam's first transgression came through the wood, and from the beginning God ordained salvation for him through the wood. For God himself is the creator and giver of life and death, and everything is performed by his word, and he created everything, and he maketh righteous him that serveth him in purity in his pure tabernacle of the law. For it is called mercy seat, and it is also called place of refuge, and it is also called altar, and it is also called place of forgiveness of sins, and it is called salvation, and it is called gate of life, and it is called glorification, and it is called City of Refuge, and it is called Ship, and it is called Haven of Salvation, and it is called House of Prayer, and it is called Place of Forgiveness of Sins for him that putteth in purity in it, so that men may pray therein in purity and not defile their bodies. God loveth the pure, for he is the habitation for the pure. Those who come into his habitation, and are accepted in the holy tabernacle, and who pray unto him with all their hearts, he will hear and will save in the day of their tribulation, and he will fulfill their desire. For he hath made the holy tabernacle to be a similitude of his throne. But there are some among those whom ye have brought unto us who are like unto us Christians, but who have not abandoned the sin which their father the devil hath made to spring up in them. And he said, Thus it is right that we should pray in Zion, the tabernacle of the law of God, she was at the first and is even now. The similitude thereof and the fruit thereof are the mother of the Redeemer, Mary, it is right that we should worship her, for in her name is blessed the tabernacle of the law of God and it is right that we should worship Michael and Gabriel. And the Archbishop Cyril answered and said unto them, And if he hath said this unto them, we also will say unto them, What did our Lord Jesus Christ say when he was teaching those who believed in him? One came from outside and said unto him, Behold them, thy father and thy mother outside seeking thee. And Christ the lover of men answered and, stretching out his hand towards those whom he was teaching, said, Without making any distinction or difference between man and woman, Behold them, my father, and my mother, and my brother. Whosoever hath heard my word and hath done the will of my father, that same is my father, and my mother, and my sister. O thou blind-hearted Jew, canst thou not see his mercy and his love for men when he spake thus? He neither separated nor made a distinction, but he said unto them, My brother. For he loveth those who love him and keep his commandment, especially the martyrs, who for his sake delivered themselves over to death, though they knew the bitterness of death, and the solitary monks who keep the commandment of God, and love him with all their hearts, and he loveth them. And their graves which are built, that is to say, the martyriums, and the churches which are built in their names, and the tabernacles which the bishops consecrate in their names, every one is holy in the house of the sanctuary of God. And the man who putteth in their names God heareth. And those who pray in purity, without uncleanness and blemish, and in humility and sincerity in a tabernacle which hath been consecrated, whether it be in the name of a martyr, or in the name of an angel, or in the name of the righteous, or in the name of a virgin, or in the name of holy women if it be consecrated, the Holy Spirit cometh down upon them and changeth the wood so that it becometh a spiritual being. In this wise God transformed the rod of Moses by his word, and it became a thing of life and made Moses fear his Lord. And in like manner Joseph worshipped the top of the rod of Jacob when he was before him, none forced him, but through the belief of his father he worshipped the top of his rod. And this which Moses wrote is a prophecy for the last days, so that we may know that tabernacles in the name of martyrs and righteous men are holy, namely, when he saw him he worshipped the top of his rod. And I will also declare unto you what is written concerning the pride of Pharaoh. Moses did as God commanded him, and turned his rod into a serpent, and Pharaoh commanded the magicians, the sorcerers, to do the same with their rods. And they made their rods into three serpents which, by means of magic, wriggled before Moses and Aaron, and before Pharaoh and the nobles of Egypt. And the rod of Moses swallowed up the rods of the magicians, for these deceivers had worked magic for the sight of the eyes of men. Now that which happeneth through the word of God overcometh every kind of magic that can be wrought. And no one can find him to be evil, for it is the Holy Spirit who guideth and directeth him that believeth with an upright heart without negligence. Even as Paul saith, By believing the fathers of olden time were saved. He wished to make known each by his name from Adam and Noah and Abraham, to Rahab the harlot who received the spies. And thou, O blind Jew, canst thou not understand from what thou readest in the law, that is to say, the Torah wherein thou believest, that inasmuch as thou canst not perform its commandments thou art cursed thereby. For when he saith, All those who walk therein, if they do not keep what is written therein, accursed shall they be, he saith it to thee. But us, who believe in Christ, the Son of God, the grace of God hath chosen, saying, He who believeth and is baptized shall be saved. 105. Concerning the belief of Abraham. And thou dost not understand that they were justified by faith, Abraham, and David and all the prophets, one after the other, who prophesied concerning the coming of the Son of God. And Abraham said, Wilt thou in my days, O Lord, cast thy word upon the ground? And God said unto him, By no means. His time hath not yet come, but I will shew thee a similitude of his coming. Get thee over the Jordan, and dip thyself in the water as thou goest over, and arrive at the city of Salem, where thou shalt meet Melchizedek, and I will command him to show thee the sign and similitude of him. And Abraham did this, and he found Melchizedek, and he gave him the mystery of the bread and wine, that same which is celebrated in our Passover for our salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ. This was the desire and the joy of Abraham as he went round the altar which Melchizedek had made, carrying branch and palm on the day of the Sabbath. See how he rejoiced in his belief, and see how he was justified by his belief, O blind Jew, who though having eyes seest not, and having ears hearest not, even as the prophet Isaiah saith concerning you, their eyes are blind, and their hearts are covered with darkness, so that they may not understand and God may not show compassion unto them. 106. A prophecy concerning the coming of Christ. And now hearken how each one of them hath prophesied concerning him, for the narrative is pleasant to hear. Isaiah the prophet prophesied concerning his coming and said, A son is born unto us. A child is given unto us. Dominion is written upon his shoulder. He is God, strong in rule, King, great counselor is his name. Now the meaning of this is manifest, the Son of God is born, whose sovereignty was written down before the world was, and he is wiser than anyone else, this is what he saith unto thee. And again Isaiah prophesied and said, Behold my servant whom I have chosen, on whom is the delight of my soul, and the nations shall put their confidence in him. And these words give us to understand that Christ is the Spirit of God, the word of the Father who put on our flesh and was born for us, and the peoples of Rome and Ethiopia and all other nations have believed in him. And he spake unto the people of Israel, and again he prophesied, saying, Many shall follow after thee with their loins girded up, and their backs bound with fetters, and they shall pray to thee and worship thee, for thou art God, and we have not recognized thee. Now this he spake concerning the martyrs, and those who became monks in the desert and solitary monks, whose hearts were fettered with his commandment, and who prayed to him, meaning that reward was meet for both the martyrs and the solitary monks. And we did not recognize thee, Israel made itself blind, and crucified him, and refused to walk in his righteousness. And again Isaiah prophesied and said, God shall come, and the heathen shall put their trust in him and shall know him, this meaneth that Christ shall come, and the Jews shall reject him, but the heathen shall believe in him. And again he prophesied and said, Be strong ye weak hands and tired knees, and rejoice ye hearts that are cast down, for God hath come, who shall requite our debt, and save us. And he shall open the eyes of the blind, and he shall make the ears of the deaf to hear, and the feet that are lame shall run, and the tongues of the dumb shall speak. These words are spoken in respect of those who err in worshipping idols, and those who are dead in sin, and those whose hearts are darkened, and of you who do not know that God created you. Rejoice ye this day, he hath come who will redeem the sin of Adam, and make Adam's debt his own. He was crucified being sinless. He hath killed death by means of his own death, and the blind see, and the lame walk, and the deaf hear, and the dumb speak unhaltingly, and besides all these things the dead are raised. This is the meaning of this prophecy. Thus David the prophet prophesied and said, God shall come in visible form, and our God will not keep silence. Thus Jeremiah prophesied and said, God shall come down upon the earth, and shall walk about with men like us. Thus Ezekiel the prophet prophesied and said, I your God will come, and I will walk about among them, and they shall know me that I am their God. Thus David prophesied and said, Blessed is he who cometh in the name of God, We have blessed you in the name of the Lord. Thus Habakkuk prophesied and said, God shall come from the south, and the Holy One from Mount Pharan and from the cities of Judah. Thus Elijah the prophet prophesied and said, With a new covenant shall God come unto us. Thus Joel the prophet prophesied and said, The heavenly Emmanuel shall come and shall deliver the work which he hath fashioned with his own hand from the hand of the devil, the deceiver, and his devils which lead astray. Thus David the prophet prophesied and said, The God of gods shall show himself in Zion. The people say out of Zion, A man is born therein, and he the Most High hath founded it. Thus Solomon his son prophesied and said, Verily God shall be with men, and he shall walk about upon the earth. Thus his father David prophesied and said, He shall come down like the dew upon wool, and like the drop which droppeth upon the earth, and righteousness shall spring into being in his days. Thus Solomon his son prophesied and said, A Savior shall be born out of Zion, and he shall remove sin from Jacob. Thus Hosea the prophet prophesied and said, I will come to thee, O Zion, and I will walk about in thee, Jerusalem, saith God, the Holy One of Israel. Thus Micah the prophet prophesied and said, The word of God shall appear in Jerusalem, and the law shall go forth from Zion. Thus Hosea the prophet prophesied and said, God shall appear upon the earth, and shall dwell with men like us. Thus Jeremiah the prophet prophesied and said, A Savior shall be sent from Zion. And he shall remove sin from the people of Israel. Thus Micah the prophet prophesied and said, God shall come from the heavens and dwell in his temple. Thus Zechariah the prophet prophesied and said, Rejoice, O daughter of Zion. Behold, I am alive, and I will dwell in thee, saith God, the Holy One of Israel. Thus Micah the prophet prophesied and said, Behold, God shall come, and shall shine upon those who fear him, Son of Righteousness is his name. Thus Hosea the prophet prophesied and said, God shall come upon thee, Jerusalem, and shall appear in the midst of thee. Thus David the prophet prophesied and said, And he shall live, and they shall give him of the gold of Arabia, and they shall pray for him continually, and he shall be the stay of all the earth upon the tops of the mountains. Thus Job the just prophesied and said, God shall walk about upon the earth, and he shall travel over the sea as upon the dry land. Thus David the prophet prophesied and said, He bowed the heavens and came down. Thus Isaiah the prophet prophesied and said, Behold, the virgin shall conceive, and shall bring forth a son, and she shall call his name Emmanuel. Thus David the prophet prophesied and said, I brought thee forth from the womb before the star of the morning. And again he said, God said unto me, Thou art my son, and I have this day brought thee forth. Thus Gideon prophesied and said, Behold, he shall come down like dew upon the earth. Thus David the prophet prophesied and said, God looked down from heaven upon the children of men, and from the temple of his sanctuary. Thus Moses the prophet prophesied and said, And all the children of God shall say, He is strong, for he even gath the blood of his sons. Thus David prophesied and said, And there will I make a horn to David to rise up, and I will prepare a lamp for mine anointed, and I will clothe his enemies with shame, and in him shall my holiness flourish. Thus Hosea the prophet prophesied and said, Fear not, for thou shalt not be put to shame. And be not dismayed because of thy praise. And again he said, hearken unto me, my people, for my judgment or justice is right. I will come and I will dwell with you, and the nations shall put their trust in my light, for the nations shall be the loved ones of Christ. Thus David the prophet said, A people whom I do not know shall serve me, at the mere hearing of the ear they shall answer me. And to the Jews he said, The children of the stranger have been false to me, the children of the stranger have become old and have travelled haltingly on their path. God liveth, and blessed is my God. When he saith unto thee, God liveth, he speaketh of his Godhead, and when he saith unto thee and blessed is my God, he speaketh concerning his putting on the flesh. And again he speaketh concerning his putting on the flesh in Isaiah the prophet, saying, Who is this glorious one who cometh forth from Edom, Adonai, who came down from heaven, and put on the things of baser, glorious in majesty. When he saith glorious, he refereth to his sweet odor, and when he saith Adonai, he meaneth the word of the Father who was before the world, the Son of God. When he saith he put on the things of baser, the glorious in majesty, he indicateth clearly the body of Adam. Thus David the prophet prophesied, saying concerning Christian folk, declare yet to the nations that God is King, and that he hath made fast the world so that it shall never be moved. And he also prophesied concerning his coming to the nations, and said, before the face of God shall he shall come and shall judge the earth, and he shall judge the world in righteousness, and the nations with justice. Thus Isaiah the prophet prophesied and said, the Lord of hosts hath planned to destroy the contumely of the nations, and he shall bring to nothing the nobles and the mighty ones of the earth. And continuing his prophecy he said, he shall come and shall build his house, and he shall deliver his people. And he added other words, saying, and at that time there shall spring from the root of Jesse one who shall be set over the nations, and the nations shall put their trust in him, and the place where he shall abide shall be glorious forever. Thus David prophesied, and said, sing ye unto God who dwelleth in Zion, and declare ye to the nation his work. Thus Solomon his son prophesied and spake concerning our Savior Emmanuel, the Son of Righteousness, he brought me forth before the hills, and before he made the lands and set them in order, and founded me before the world, before he made the earth, and before he made the abysses, and before the water floods came forth, and the beauty of the flowers appeared, and before the winds blew, God created his work before his face, and I existed conjointly with my father. Thus his father David prophesied and said, his name was before the sun, and before the moon, generation to generation. Thus his son Solomon prophesied and said, when he made strong the firmament above the clouds, and when he set in position the walls of the boundaries of the heavens, and when he set the sea in its appointed place, and before he founded his throne above the winds, and when he made strong the foundations of the earth, I existed conjointly with him. I was that wherein he rejoiced continually, and day by day, and I exulted with him at all times before his face. Thus Job the prophet prophesied and said, the face of my God is in the east, and his light is before that of the sun, and the nations put their trust in his name. Thus Isaiah the prophet prophesied and said, remember ye not the things of the past, and think not about the things of olden time, behold, I will make a new thing, which shall now spring up, so that ye may know that I make a road through the desert and water floods in the wilderness, and the beasts of the field shall follow after me, and the young birds, and the ostriches. For I have given water in the desert, and made streams of water to flow in the wilderness, so that I may give drink to my people and to my chosen ones whom I have gotten, so that they may declare my glory, and perform my commandment. Thus Solomon prophesied and said, who hath gone up into heaven and come down? And who hath gathered together the winds in his bosom? And who hath collected the waters in his garment? And who hath measured the waters of the sea in his hand, and the heavens on the palm of his hand? And what is his name and what is the name of his son? Thus Micah the prophet prophesied and said unto the Jews, I have no pleasure in you, saith God who ruleth all things. And I have no pleasure in your offerings, and I will accept no gift from your hands. For from the rising of the sun to the setting thereof shall my name be praised among all peoples, and in all countries incense shall be offered up to my great name among all peoples, saith Almighty God. And again Micah the prophet said, a new covenant shall appear upon the mountain of God, and it shall be prepared upon the tops of the mountains, and it shall be exalted above the hills, and people shall say, come ye, let us go up into the mountain of God. And many nations shall go thereto and shall say, come ye, let us go up into the mountain of God, and they shall declare unto us his way, and we will walk therein. Thus David the prophet prophesied and said, hearken unto me, O my people, and I will speak unto thee, Israel, and will bring testimony to thee, I am God, thy God. Thus Moses the prophet prophesied and said concerning the Trinity, hear, O Israel, the Lord thy God is one. And this is to be explained thus, Father, and Son, and Holy Spirit are one God, whose kingdom is one, whose dominion is one, and as one men shall worship them in the heavens and in the earth, in the sea and in the abysses. And to him be praise forever and ever. Amen. 107. Concerning his entrance into Jerusalem in glory. And the prophets have prophesied concerning his glorious entry into Jerusalem, and Isaiah the prophet said, shine thou, Jerusalem, thy light hath come and the glory of God hath risen upon thee. Thus the prophet Zechariah prophesied and said, rejoice, rejoice, daughter of Zion, and let Jerusalem shout for joy. Thus David prophesied and said, out of the mouth of children and babes thou hast prepared praise because of the enemy, so that thou mightest overthrow the enemy and the avenger. Thus Solomon prophesied and said, the children are taught by God, and the peoples rejoice within thee. Thus David his father prophesied and said, blow ye the horn in Zion, on the day of the new moon, on the appointed day of our festival, for it is an ordinance for Israel. Thus Ezra the scribe prophesied and said, get ye out, make ye a festival in gladness, and say unto the daughter of Zion, rejoice thou, behold thy king hath come. Thus Isaiah the prophet prophesied and said, rejoice thou, Jerusalem, rejoice thou. Behold, thy king hath come riding upon an ass. His reward is with him, and his work is before his face. Thus David the prophet prophesied and said, blessed is he who cometh in the name of the Lord. Thus Jacob the son of Isaac prophesied and said, Judah, thy brethren have praised thee. Thine hand is upon the back of thine enemy, and the children of thy mother shall worship thee. And the dominion shall not diminish from Judah, and the government shall not depart from his kin, until he shall find him who hath been waited for, and who is the hope of the nations. And he also prophesied and said, his teeth are white as with snow, and his eyes are glad as with wine, and he shall wash his apparel in wine and his tunic in the blood of clusters of grapes. And again he prophesied, saying, Judah is a lion's whelp, thou hast lain down, and thou hast slept, no one shall wake him up except him that hunteth until he findeth him, rise up from thy strong place. And again Jacob blessed his son Judah, and said unto him, there is a king who shall go forth from thee and shall wash his apparel in wine, and glorious is the place of rest of the beloved. Now, by beloved Christ is meant, and by Messiah Christ is meant. And Jesus meaneth Savior of the people. Now the prophets mention Christ under a secret name and they call him the Beloved. And Isaiah spake concerning his ascension in his prophecy, saying, on that day the Beloved shall come down from heaven, and shall choose for himself 12 apostles. And again he said, I have seen the ascension of the Beloved Son to the seventh heaven, and the angels and the archangels receiving him, he being very much higher than they. And David said, the Beloved is like the son of the unicorn, and again he said, and thine only one from the horns of the unicorn. And again he said, let my horn be exalted like that of the unicorn. Horns meaneth the kingdoms of the world, and unicorn meaneth he who is over his kingdom whom no one can resist, for he is the governor of kings, he destroyeth whom he will and he setteth up him whom he will. Even as David saith, I will make thee to rejoice more than those who are mighty through their horns, which meaneth, thou art nobler than the noble kings, and thou dost rejoice. And Habakkuk prophesied, saying, horns are in his hands, and he hath placed the Beloved in the strength of his power, which meaneth, the palms of the hand, wherein the life of all is held, of the holder of the dominion of kings, are pierced with nails, which Christ, the Beloved, hath endured in the strength of his might. 108. Concerning the wickedness of the iniquitous Jews. And the prophets prophesied concerning the wickedness of the Jews. And David said concerning it, the man of violence hunteth iniquity to destroy himself. And again he saith, his sorrow shall return upon his head, and his iniquity upon his forehead. Thus Solomon his son prophesied and said, the foolish man and the man of iniquity travel by paths that are not straight. He winketh with the eye, and tappeth with the foot, and he giveth a sign by movements of the fingers and motion of the lips, and his perverted heart meditateth evil at all times, A man who is like this will make to come tumult and murder, and the shedding of blood through double dealing, and he shall not escape the judgment. And David his father prophesied and said, They brought forth against me the word of error, he who sleepeth shall he not awake? Shall then the man of my peace, namely, my friend, whom I trusted, who ate my food, lift up his foot against me? Thus Isaiah the prophet prophesied and said, Woe be unto the man of iniquity who bringeth wrath. And again he said, Let them remove the sinner so that he may not see the glory of God. Thus David the prophet prophesied and said, The sinner speaketh what will condemn him, and there is no fear of God before his eyes. Thus Solomon his son prophesied and said, The man of iniquity bringeth tumult to the city, and he willingly maketh to come destruction, and beating, and calamity which cannot be healed, for he rejoiceth in everything which God hateth. Thus prophesied Moses the prophet and said, God wisheth not to forgive him but rather to increase vengeance upon him, and he will make punishments to rest upon him, and the curse which is written in this book shall come upon him, and his name shall be blotted out from under heaven. Thus David the prophet prophesied and said, His heart is ready for slaughter, he preferreth cursing and it shall come to him, he refuseth blessing and it shall be far from him. Thus Jeremiah the prophet prophesied concerning him and said, The man of iniquity shall be destroyed because of the love of money, and he looked upon darkness because of his fraud. Thus Job prophesied and said concerning him, His creator will destroy his fair work, and his root shall dry up under him, and his flower shall be beaten down upon him, and his memorial shall be blotted out from the earth, and his name shall be cast far away, and men shall remove him into the darkness so that he may not see the light, and the house of the man of iniquity shall be blotted out. Thus Hosea prophesied and said concerning him, Hearken unto me, O children of Israel, for there is no righteousness, and no mercy, and no fear of God in his heart, but falsehood, and theft, and murder, and fornication. And David the prophet prophesied and said, Satan standeth at his right hand and again he said, Let another take his office. And Moses cursed in the law and said, Cursed be every one who taketh bribes to slay innocent blood, and all the people said, Amen. And Amen. Thus Habakkuk the prophet prophesied and said, The governor maketh men wise concerning this perversion of the law, and no right judgment cometh forth, for the sinner corrupteth the righteous man, and therefore a perverted judgment cometh forth. Thus David the prophet prophesied and said, The sinner seeth and becometh wrathful, and he gnasheth with his teeth and is dissolved. Thus Solomon his son prophesied and said, A false balance is a hateful thing to God. Thus Jeremiah prophesied and said concerning Judah, My hire is ready or, weighed for me, 30 pieces of silver. 109. Concerning his crucifixion. And the prophets also prophesied concerning the crucifixion of Christ. Thus Moses, the servant of God, prophesied and said, Ye shall see your salvation crucified upon the wood, and shall not believe. Thus David prophesied and said, Many dogs have seized me, and they drove nails through my hands and my feet, and they counted all my bones, though they knew me they despised me, and they divided my garments among themselves, and they cast lots for my apparel. Thus Isaiah prophesied concerning the incarnation and crucifixion of Christ, and said, Who believeth our word, and to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? And we spake like a child before him, and he is like a root in parched ground, he hath no beauty and no form, and his form is more rejected and abased than that of any man. He is a broken man and a man of suffering, for he hath turned away his face, and they treat him with contempt and esteem him as nothing. Thus Solomon prophesied and said, Let us kill the righteous man, for he is a burden unto us, he setteth himself up against our works, he resisteth our intentions continually, and we are an abomination unto him because of our sins. And he continued, saying, My son, let not wicked men lead thee astray, if they say unto thee, Come with us, be a partner with us, let us hide innocent blood and take plunder from him, and let there be one purse common to us all, withdraw thyself from their footsteps, for let it not be through thee that the birds find the net. Thus David prophesied and said, they cast gall into my meat, and they gave me vinegar to drink to quench my thirst. Thus prophesied Isaiah the prophet and said, He hath taken our disease and carried our sickness, and by his wound we are healed, and we saw him suffering, and wounded in his pain. And he opened not his mouth in his pain, and he came to be slaughtered, like a lamb before his shearer he opened not his mouth in his suffering until they took away his life, and they knew not his birth, through the sin of my people have I come even unto death. Thus Jeremiah the prophet prophesied and said, And they took the price of the honorable 130 pieces of silver, whom they had honored among the children of Israel. And God said unto me, Cast it into the melting pot, and test it and see if it be pure, and they gave it for the field of the potter, as God hath commanded me I will speak. Thus Isaiah the prophet prophesied and said, They counted him with the sinners, and brought him to death. Thus David the prophet prophesied and said, Those who hate me wrongfully are many, and they have rewarded me with evil for good. Thus Zechariah the prophet prophesied and said, Oh, and they shall look upon him whom they have crucified and pierced. Now there are still very many passages which have been written and many prophecies which might be mentioned concerning his coming, and his crucifixion, and his death, and his resurrection, and his second coming in glory. But we have only mentioned a few of the prophecies of the prophets, we have mentioned one of each kind, so that ye may hear, and believe, and understand, even as it is said in the Acts of the Apostles, By the gospel thou hast guided us, and by the prophets thou hast comforted us, for the words of the prophets make right the faith of those who doubt. 110. Concerning his resurrection. And the prophet David also prophesied, concerning his resurrection and said, I will arise, saith the Lord, and I will make salvation and manifest it openly. And again he saith, Rise up, O Lord, and judge the earth, for thou shalt inherit among the nations. And he also prophesied and said, Rise up, O Lord, help us, and deliver us for thy name's sake. And again he said, Let God arise and let his enemies be scattered, and let his enemies flee from before his face. And he also prophesied and said, God hath risen up like one who hath woke up from sleep, and like a mighty man who hath left his wine. Thus Isaiah the prophet prophesied and said, He will remove sickness from his soul, for he hath not committed sin, and falsehood hath not been found in his mouth. And to him that hath served righteousness and good will he show light and he will justify him, and he shall do away the sins of many, for he hath not committed sin, and falsehood is not found in his mouth. Thus prophesied David the prophet and said, For my soul shall not be left in hell. Thus Solomon his son prophesied and said, The son of righteousness shall arise, and shall travel towards the right, and shall return into his place. 111. Concerning his ascension and his second coming. Thus all the prophets and many of the early fathers prophesied concerning his ascension and his second coming to judge the living and the dead. And David said concerning his resurrection, He hath gone up into the heights. Thou hast made captive captivity, and hast given grace to the children of men. And he also said, Having gone forth, I will come back, and I will return from the abyss of the sea. And again he said, Sing ye unto God who hath gone up into the heavens which are opposite the morning. Thus Amos the prophet prophesied and said, The Messiah, who made the time of the morning, hath come and is exalted from the earth into the heights, and his name is God who ruleth all things. Thus prophesied David the prophet and said, Thou art exalted, O Lord, by thy might, and we will praise and hymn thy strength. Thus prophesied Zechariah the prophet and said, His foot standeth on the Mount of Olives to the east of Jerusalem. And he rideth upon the cherubim, and he flieth upon the wing of the winds. Thus David said, Open ye the gates of the princes, and let the doors which were from the creation be opened, and the King of glory shall come. Who is this King of glory? God, the mighty and strong one, God, the mighty one in battle. And he also made known and said, Open ye the gates of princes, and let the doors which were from the creation be opened, and the King of glory shall come. Who is this King of glory? The Lord God of hosts is this King. And again concerning his coming, he shall judge the living and the dead, he to whom belongeth glory forever and ever. Amen. Thus Zechariah the prophet prophesied and said, That day the Lord my God shall come, and all his saints with him. Thus David the prophet prophesied and said, God spake once, and this according to what I have heard, compassion belongeth unto God. And thine, O Lord, is the power, for thou wilt reward every man according to his work. Thus spake Daniel the prophet and said, I saw in my vision by night, and behold, there came one like unto the Son of Man to the Ancient of Days, and there were given unto him dominion, and glory, and sovereignty, and all the nations and peoples and countries shall serve him, and his dominion shall have no end forever and ever. Amen. And all the prophets prophesied, and nothing that hath happened hath been without the prophecy of the prophets. And they have declared everything that hath happened, and what shall happen, what hath been done and what shall be done, and that which belongeth to the times of old and that which belongeth to the latter days up to his second coming. And this they have done not only by what they have prophesied and declared, but together with their prophecies they have given manifestations of him in their bodies. And there was a famine in the land of Canaan, and our father Abraham went down to Egypt, and came back with much riches and honor without blemish. And in like manner our Redeemer went down and delivered the church, the assembly of the nations, and he went up again, having gotten honor and praise. 112. How the prophets foreshadowed him in their persons. Isaac commanded his father, saying, Bind me, and he was offered up as a sacrifice, though he did not die, being redeemed by the ram which came down from heaven. And in like manner the Son of God was obedient to his father even unto death. And he was bound with the love of men, and he was nailed to the cross and was pierced, and the Son of God became our ransom, and his Godhead suffered not. Thus Jacob his son departed to the land of Labo-Laban, the country of his mother's brother, with his staff only, and there he made many cattle, and acquired beasts both clean and unclean, and he begot 12 sons, and he revealed baptism, and returned to his own country where he received a blessing from Isaac his father. And in like manner our Lord Christ came down from heaven, the word of Godhead by itself, and the staff of Jacob wherewith he pastured his sheep is Our Lady Mary our salvation. And moreover, the staff signifieth the wood of the cross whereby, being crucified upon it, he redeemed his flock and took possession of us from among the Jews, and the heathen, and the Gentiles. And he chose for himself 12 apostles, and they made the people believe in all the earth and in every country, and he went up to heaven to his father. Thus Moses departed to the country of Midian, and there he held converse with God, who made him to learn and to know the belief in the resurrection from the dead of his fathers Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And by means of his staff or rod he endowed him with the power to perform miracles, and he begot 2 sons. And this showeth clearly that we shall be saved by the Trinity. As the mouth of God proclaimed, I am the God of Abraham this of the father and the God of Isaac this of the son and the God of Jacob when he saith this it is of the Holy Ghost indicating the Trinity clearly and plainly. I am not the God of the dead, but the God of the living, for they all are alive with God, and by this the resurrection of the dead is to be understood. Jonah was swallowed up and cast into the belly of the great fish, and our Redeemer went down into the heart of the earth, and rose again the third day. And Daniel was cast into the pit of the lions, and the king and the Lord sealed it with their seals, and he rose up therefrom without the lions devouring him. And similarly our Lord was cast into the grave, and the Jews sealed it with their seals, imagining that they were sealing up the rising of the sun so that it should not shine. O ye foolish, wicked, blasphemous, blind, and weak-minded men, would ye assert that the spirit of life should not appear and come forth? And the Jews were put to shame, and he went forth to illumine us who have believed upon him. Joseph was sold by the hand of his brethren, and our Lord was sold by the hand of Judah. And Joseph where he was sold delivered his brethren from the famine, and Christ hath delivered us who believed upon him and hath made us his heirs and his brethren. And as Joseph gave an inheritance unto his kinsfolk in the land of Gesem Goshen, so shall Christ give unto his righteous ones a habitation, an everlasting inheritance. and moreover, in order that ye may know and understand and be certain about the resurrection of the dead, I will give you a sign, which ye shall understand by the guidance of his word. When Abraham had come unto the land of his inheritance, he bought first of all a tomb wherein to gather together the dead bodies of his kinsfolk, and his children, and his wife, so that he might join them in the resurrection, and there he buried his wife Sarah, and he himself was buried. For he was a prophet, and he knew that he would be raised up with his kin. And Isaac and Rebekah his wife were also buried there. And it remained their possession from the time when Jacob went down to the land of Egypt with 77 souls, because of the famine and because Joseph his son was there, until their number became 600,000 marching men who were equipped for war, without reckoning women and children. And Jacob died in Egypt at a good old age, and he said unto Joseph his soul, adjure thee by the life of my father and by my God, who is the renewer of my life, that thou bury me not in this country, but in the tomb of my fathers, so that my death may be with them and my life subsequently with them. Know then by the similitude of the word. And Joseph his son carried Israel and buried him by the grave of his fathers, for he reverenced the oath which Jacob had made him to swear. And again, when Jacob fell sick in Egypt, he called his brethren and his children, and made them to swear that they would not leave his bones in the land of Egypt, and said, when God maketh you to return, take ye my bones with you and mingle them in the grave of my fathers. 113. Concerning the chariot and the vanquisher of the enemy. And the archbishops or patriarchs answered and said unto Gregory, the worker of wonders, behold now, we know well, and thou hast made us to understand that the kings of Ethiopia have become glorious and great through Zion. And the kings of Rome also have become great because of the nails of the cross that Helena made into a bridle, which hath become the vanquisher of the enemy for the king of Rome. And the chariot belongeth to the king of Ethiopia, and it hath vanquished his enemy. And tell us also how long the vanquisher of the enemy shall remain with the king of Rome, and the chariot containing Zion with the king of Ethiopia. Tell us, for God hath revealed unto thee what hath been, and what shall be, vision and prophecy, like Moses and Elijah. And Gregory answered and said unto them, I will reveal unto you concerning the king of Rome when he shall transgress and shall provoke God to wrath in the faith. This faith which we have ordered and laid down shall a king transgress who shall come in Rome, and there shall be associated with him a certain archbishop, and they shall change and pervert the word of the 12 apostles, and they shall cast it aside in the desire of their heart, and they shall teach what they wish, and they shall turn the scriptures to suit their own nature, even as the apostle saith, they have behaved themselves like the people of Sodom and Gomorrah. And our Lord said unto his disciples in the gospel, guard ye yourselves against those who shall come unto you in the apparel of sheep, and who are inwardly wolves that tear. And when they have destroyed the faith, the vanquisher of the enemy shall be taken away from them, and there shall be none of those who have changed our faith who shall sit upon the throne of Peter, and the bowels of their archbishops shall be emptied out if they have taken their seat upon it in perverted faith. For the angel of God hath been commanded to protect the throne of Peter in Rome. And God shall take away the vanquisher of the enemy from the king who shall not guard the faith, and the Persians shall make war upon him and defeat him, and it seemeth to me that his name is Martian the Apostate. And the king of Persia, whose name is Harinous Irenaus, shall conquer him, and the king shall carry him away, together with his horse, and by the will of God the horse on which is the vanquisher of the enemy shall be stirred up, and shall go into the sea and perish therein. But the nails shall shine there in the sea until Christ shall come again in great glory upon a cloud of heaven, together with power. Now this hath God showed me in the pit. And as concerning the king of Ethiopia, and Zion, the bride of heaven, and her chariot whereby they move, I will declare unto you that which my God hath revealed unto me and hath made me to understand. Ethiopia shall continue in the Orthodox faith until the coming of our Lord, and she shall in no way turn aside from the word of the apostles, and it shall be so even as we have ordered until the end of the world. And one answered and said unto the worker of wonders, namely, Gregory, now when Samaliel cometh, who is the false Christ Antichrist, will the faith of the people of Ethiopia be destroyed by his attack? And Gregory answered and said, Assuredly not. Hath not David prophesied, saying, Ethiopia shall make her hands come to God? And this that he saith meaneth that the Ethiopians will neither pervert nor change this our faith and what we have ordered, and the faith of those who were before us the teachers of the law of the apostles. 114. Concerning the return of Zion. And the tabernacle of the law of God, the holy Zion, shall remain here until that day when our Lord shall dwell on Mount Zion, and Zion shall come and shall appear unto all prepared, with three seals, even as Moses gave Harisit Seth in the old law and in the new, at the testimony of two or three witnesses everything shall stand. And then, saith Isaiah the prophet, the dead shall be raised up, and those who are in the graves shall live, for the dew which cometh from thee is their life. And when the dead are raised up, his mercy whereby he watereth the earth shall cease, they shall stand up before him with the works which they have done. And Enoch and Elias shall come, being alive, so that they may testify, and Moses and Aaron from the dead shall live with everyone. And they shall open the things that fetter her, namely, Zion, and they shall make to be seen the Jews, the crucifiers, and they shall punish them and chide them because of all that they have done in perverting the word of God. And the Jews shall see what he wrote for them with his hand, words of his commandment, and the manna wherewith he fed them without toil on their part, and the measure thereof, the gomer, and the spiritual Zion, which came down for their salvation, and the rod of Aaron, which blossomed after the manner of Mary. 115. Concerning the judgment of Israel. And he shall answer and say unto them, Why did ye deny me, and entreat me evilly and crucify me, seeing that I did all this for you, and that by my coming down from heaven I delivered you from Satan and from the slavery of Satan, and that I came for your sakes? Look ye and see how ye pierced me with nails and thrust the spear through me. And the 12 apostles shall be raised up, and they shall pass judgment upon them, and shall say unto them, We would have made you hear, but ye would not hear the prophecy of the prophets and the preaching of us the apostles. And the Jews shall weep and repent when it shall be useless to do so, and they shall pass into everlasting punishment, and with the devil, their father who had directed them, and his demons who had led them astray, and with the wicked they shall be shut in. And those who have believed and who have been baptized in the Holy Trinity, and have received his body and his blood, shall become his servants with their whole heart, for there is no one who can hate his body altogether. The body of Christ crieth out in our body, and he hath compassion because of his body and blood, for they have become his sons and his brethren. And if there be some who have sinned, they shall be judged in the fire according to the quantity of their sins. He whose burden of sin is light, his punishment shall be light, and he whose burden of sin is heavy, exceedingly great shall his punishment be. One day with God is as a period of 10,000 years. Some there shall be who shall be punished for a day, and some for half a day, and some for 3 hours of a day, and some for 1 hour of a day, and some there shall be who shall be tested and who shall be absolved from their transgressions. 116. Concerning the chariot of Ethiopia. And the archbishops answered and said unto Gregory, the worker of wonders, Behold now, thou hast told us concerning the vanquisher of the enemy of Rome, and now tell us of the chariot of Ethiopia and whether it shall remain henceforward, to the coming of Christ, as thou hast told us concerning Zion, and concerning the faith of the people of Ethiopia, and likewise if their chariot shall remain. And Gregory said unto them, It shall assuredly not disappear. And again, Hearken ye unto me, and I will declare this unto you, a few Jews shall lift up their heads against our faith in Nagran and in Armenia in the days after this, and this God will do by his will so that he may destroy them, for Armenia is a territory of Rome and Nagran is a territory of Ethiopia. 117. Concerning the King of Rome and the King of Ethiopia. And the King of Rome, and the King of Ethiopia, and the Archbishop of Alexandria. Now the men of Rome were Orthodox, were informed that they were to destroy them. And they were to rise up to fight, to make war upon the enemies of God, the Jews, and to destroy them, the King of Rome Enya, and the King of Ethiopia Pinh.as Phinehas, and they were to lay waste their lands, and to build churches there, and they were to cut to pieces Jews at the end of the cycle in 12 cycles of the moon. Then the kingdom of the Jews shall be made an end of, and the kingdom of Christ shall be constituted until the advent of the false Messiah. And those two kings, Justinus the king of Rome and Caleb the king of Ethiopia, met together in Jerusalem. And their archbishop was to make ready offerings, and they were to make offerings, and they were to establish the faith in love, and they were to give each other gifts and the salutation of peace, and they were to divide between them the earth from the half of Jerusalem, even as we have already said at the beginning of this book. And for love's sake they were to have jointly the royal title of king of Ethiopia. They were to be mingled with David and Solomon their fathers. The one whom in faith they chose by lot to be named from the kings of Rome was to be called king of Ethiopia, and the king of Rome likewise was to bear the name of king of Ethiopia, and he was to have part in the lot whereby he should be named with David and Solomon their fathers, after the manner of the four evangelists. And the fourth the one whom they were to choose each in his own country. And thus after they had become united in a common bond, and had established the right faith, they were to determine that the Jews were no longer to live, and each of them was to leave his son there, and the king of Ethiopia was to leave there his firstborn son whose name was Israel, and was to return to his own country in joy. And when he came to his royal house, he was to give abundant thanks unto God, and to offer up his body as an offering of praise to his God. And God shall accept him gladly, for he shall not defile his body after he hath returned, but he shall go into a monastery in purity of heart. And he shall make king his youngest son, whose name is Gabra Masel, and he himself shall shut himself up in a monastery. And when one hath told this to the king of Nagran, the son of Caleb, he shall come in order to reign over Zion, and Gabra Masel shall make his armies to rise up, and he shall journey in a chariot, and they shall meet together at the narrow end of the Sea of Libba, and shall fight together. And on the same night the two of them shall pray from sunset until the dawn, when the fight waxed strong upon them. And when they have cried out to him with tears, God will look upon the prayer of both of them, and the penitent prayer of their father, and will say, "This one is the elder, and he hath stood up to perform the will of his father, and that one, the younger, hath loved his father, and hath prayed to God for him." And God will say to Gabra Masel, "Choose thou between the chariot and Zion," and he will cause him to take Zion, and he shall reign openly upon the throne of his father. And God will make Israel to choose the chariot, and he shall reign secretly and he shall not be visible, and he will send him to all those who have transgressed the commandment of God. And no one shall build houses, and they shall live in tents, and none shall suffer fatigue in laboring, and none shall suffer thirst on the journey. And their days shall be double of those of ordinary men, and they shall use bows and arrows, and shall shoot at and pierce him that God hath. Thus hath God made for the king of Ethiopia more glory, and grace, and majesty than for all the other kings of the earth, because of the greatness of Zion, the tabernacle of the law of God, the heavenly Zion. And may God make us to perform his spiritual good pleasure, and deliver us from his wrath, and make us to share his kingdom. Amen. And they answered and said unto him, "Verily, thou hast spoken well, for thus was it revealed unto thee by the help of the Holy Spirit. Thou hast told us everything which hath taken place, and thou art in agreement with the book of Damodius Domitius of Rome. And thou hast prophesied also what shall happen to the two cities, the brides of Christ, the churches Nestasia and Arlsadia and Marina and Ethiopia, the great cities of God, wherein pure sacrifices and offerings shall be offered up at all times. May God show us his grace. The blessing of all the saints and martyrs be with us forever and ever. Amen. Christ is our King, and in Christ is our life forever and ever. Amen. And amen." Colophon. In the Arabic text it is said, "We have turned this book into Arabic from a Coptic Egyptian cursive manuscript belonging to the throne of Mark the Evangelist, the teacher, the father of us all. We have translated it in the 409th year of mercy in the country of Ethiopia, in the days of Gabra Masselzel the king, who is called Lalibala, in the days of Abba George, the good bishop. And God neglected to have it translated and interpreted into the speech of Abyssinia. And when I had pondered this, why did not Abalizi and Abalfarog, who edited or copied the book, translate it? I said this, it went out in the days of Zigwa, and they did not translate it because this book says, those who reign not being Israelites are transgressors of the law. Had they been of the kingdom of Israel, they would have translated it. And it was found in Nazareth. And pray ye for me, your servant Isaac the poor man. And chide ye me not because of the incorrectness of the speech of the tongue. For I have toiled much for the glory of the country of Ethiopia, and for the going forth of the heavenly Zion, and for the glory of the king of Ethiopia. And I consulted the upright and God-loving governor Yaebika Egzi, and he approved and said unto me, work. And I worked, God helping me, and he did not requite me according to my sins. And pray ye for your servant Isaac, and for those who toiled with me in the production of this book, for we were in sore tribulation, I, and Yamharanob, and Hesbachrestos, and Andrew, and Philip, and Mahatab. May God have mercy upon them, and may he write their names in the book of life in the kingdom of heaven, with those of all the saints and martyrs forever and ever. Amen.